That's all the legend I could get. Alright, everyone. So this here is Fortune Cookie. For PC. The game is submitted by Sky of Steel. The goal is to play it until it gets voted out, or until we beat it, whichever comes first. An interesting thing about this game is that it was originally released in Russia, with a completely different story, apparently. What am I running it on? On Windows 7, but I run it on a Windows 95 emulator. So here we go. I don't really know what to expect for this. Here we go. Sucker, slacker, or hacker? Slacker sounds like the default. We'll go with that. Try throwing these stones. You want to take it? Yes. I'm sorry, Slacker, you don't have enough cash. Yeah, Penguin, like me too. I was thinking, like, that sounds like a cool, like, dark story, not this. This is so far from what I expected. You got a telegram from Professor Chang, Mr. Slacker. Looking kind of weird, Frank. Has Mitchell... Wait. Mass Mitchell wouldn't like you back home like that, haha. Now listen, your only chance to become normal again is to destroy Blagoon. Oh, Mrs. Mitchell. The stones are ammo. And this is the quest hub, I guess. Got item. There's no height. There's a standard height of jumping. Scuba diving. Don't jump high enough. Last, yes. Damn commies. Picked up money. can't swim. You need a car to travel to Orient Express. It's an oxygen bar? Wait, why'd I die? What the fuck is going on? Yeah, but like, why did I run out of oxygen? I was out of the water just before. Yeah, the blue bar at the bottom, but why didn't it refill? Refill it by buying. Oh. Now I'm out of weapons. Picked up a door key. I need to use scuba tanks even though I like swim by the This is so weird. What the fuck am I supposed to do? It feels like I'm missing something. Weirdly disturbing. Yeah. But now I have 2 money. And all of these things. $100 for a shovel. Smart missiles. $150. $100. $50. I have $2. 25 for 25 kilograms. It's interesting as well, it's space to open, but it's enter to choose an alternative. Yeah, 2 won't buy much. I can't climb. It looks like it's supposed to be vines. These things, but it isn't. Oh. Ah. There's a secret. Alright, we're getting somewhere. The platforming is so damn weird. Now we can take the Orient Express. Can I save? Mm-hmm. That was a weirdly disturbing travel animation. Oh. Those things are bad. We need a green key. God damn it. Our full health so we can pick up the pumpkin. Oh well, the green key. Oh well. We've gotten somewhere. X press. We're getting somewhere. Damn it. The fact that you just throw rocks in weird ass directions is annoying, but I like the fact that save's coming already. I mean, what are you supposed to do? Come on. There we go. Syndicate got voted out? Yes, it did. Syndicate got voted out, and then we played. Here's your telegram, Mr. Slacker. Your path now lies to where the owl sits. And then we played Raging Justice for 2.5 hours, and now we're playing this. Yeah, something about owls. What? Oh. Green key. What? Oh, I'm dead now. I might as well reload, I guess. Unless I find a full health soon. Is that an enemy or a good thing? Picked up money. Alright. Could have been worse. Kim. Don't mess with the bees. No. Apparently not. Not an affair, you say? Go to town of Drazang. I'm sure they can arrange something there. This is so weird. Sword. Gonna die soon. Thank you. If you just moved slightly faster by default. Maybe I should go get that sword. It seems like a pretty good thing to have. Ah, oh, shit, yeah, I forgot these. You cut down the flames? Go figure. Like, how do I get up from here? Welcome to Silicon Hills. Jesus. This is probably among the weirdest titles I've played in a very long while. What? What exactly is this game? Yeah, it's... I think it's sort of like Metroidvania. Now that's... that's a plug that I would buy. It's a weird Russian platformer with Metroidvania elements. What is not to love? This time I'm actually pretty well off. Stuff deals so much damage. Don't touch any other button while you're climbing. You will fall. Green key. I'm so sad, Slacker. Little Titok lost her peacock and doesn't know where to find him. Leave her alone and bring him home, hoping all along beside you. We need to find a peacock. And by the way, what is bird? Oh. I think there are kites, yeah, but I don't know what they do. Kites are just for points. Okay. Yeah, they are. See in the bottom right corner it says score. It's barely visible. Drazang. So we're supposed to be able to buy... Somewhere around here we can buy more... oxygen. Sounds rather western. It's pretty annoying actually. Most of the time you start a conversation or something by pressing space, but you exit it by pressing enter. It's a really weird, like, behavioral pattern, I feel. Give me 10 coins, sure. Say this game is pretty bad. We ate a fortune cookie and got turned into this troll. And we need to defeat a goblin king. Yeah, but it's all the... It's like you're so fragile. Magic powder, no. Water bombs, no. This looks like a restaurant. Oh. My name is Blues. Blues, loose hair. I used to be a happy rabbit, hopping about, mugging the turtles. Then came a disaster. Willy the crocoblaster, who mugged me. He ate up all my carrots and said, "I don't need any since I'm a vegetable myself now." You can only bring me a carrot, slacker. That's pretty rough. Thank you. Like, where did I buy... Where did I buy... oxygen. Bao. So, the main problem with the game, as it is right now, is how incredibly limited your options for fighting is. It is incredibly hard to hit anything with this sword. It is far too short. Everything deals far too much damage. Wait, why didn't that one die? That's odd. Save here. Fly over here is difficult to get past. Jumping and attacking at the same time doesn't work. Or like, you can't do them in a very quick succession. I don't have the health to spare, I'm sorry, I just don't. Yo. Why can't you jump up here? Or here? It's clearly a space there. Oh, these roofs? Well, that thing you fall through. I guess that's the... exactly, that's the thing they're trying to tell you. I was about to say something incredibly racist, but I will not. I guess it wasn't racist, but more like... Is there a word for, like, racism against cultures? Probably shouldn't talk about this. It's one of those topics that you should just leave alone. Eating roasted chicken. Exactly. That's what they were trying to teach us all along. God damn it. Shit, my dick is empty. That's where they got the roasted chicken from, yeah. Maybe they do it in another game that's similar to this. Why can't you stand on this one? You can stand on all the others, but not that one. The thing that you suddenly enter like burst speed is so annoying. Hey, a carrot. Huh. Wonder if that's an enemy. Yep. Thought I had triggered that one already. Alright, but now we have the carrot. Let's save. In case we're like, oh, boss fight! Wanna trade for some air? Yes. Sweet. Never know. Suddenly they're like... Bunny just jumps out of his bed and is all like, Jesus. Enemies have respawned? Some of them have. He offers refills too. It's good to know. I'm gonna load up because I took so much damage. I just wanna like check what's down here. there's anything of use, or is it just money? I don't get why they can shoot projectiles. God damn it. We have mosquitoes that shoots projectiles? No, actually we don't. They're I haven't come this far. Why does fish explode? We don't have exploding fish either around here. What about this weapon? Everything is really lousily made. Bombfish, native to Thailand. Ah, well, that explains. Like, how are you supposed to get past here? No. Wrong one. This requires some pretty damn precise swimming. There was an oxygen refill. What the fuck? If an area is too difficult, who do you take me for? I'm almost insulted. Fuck. Dealt surprisingly little damage. Fuck. I should have said check the description. Maybe you're right. Maybe I'm just wasting my time here. Mm. one of those. Really? Shit. Picked up money. Can I hit this? Oh, I can. God damn it. Was so close. We are making progress though. Also that you can't attack downward with the sword is pretty troublesome. That probably would have been immensely helpful. I guess I was just somewhat like hoping they'd think about some of the parts. That's probably where I'm headed in the end. Pulsing blue thing in the water, it refills your breathing meter. Ah, it was extra oxygen. I thought I'd be going the same way back. That's why I left it. I might as well pick it up here. Get to that red key. How hard is it to read my manuscript? The night is long, which never finds the day. What? Why don't you check that door frame? What door frame? There we go. Next to where you left the water. I must have missed something. Oh, this one? Ah, but it's nothing. this one though. You need a card to travel on the Orient Express. Wait, so there's nothing here. There's nothing here in the end. That sucks. That really sucks, doesn't it? Gray double door. I think the problem is the flame deals one damage every frame, which effectively just kills you outright. You need a gray key. There's the Orient Express over there. Yeah, yay. Olven must have resubmitted it. Yeah, we could try to bomb it. Right, the tutorial said something about bombing stuff. I don't want to take so much damage though. That's at least how you're supposed to do it. No. It is ridiculous how much damage everything deals. I can bomb my way in here too. Nope. Might be able to bomb from the other side. I'm taking the bottle of bees. I just wanna try out to bomb some walls first. That worked. Then we know. Oh, not that one. Picked up tower key. Ah, don't worry about it. Don't worry. Now it's time for some. Oh, it didn't last long. Well, I got what I wanted. We can save over that one. Jesus. I did get the tower key as well. I did get the tower key, so I got something out of it. I'm not sure what the tower key is supposed to be used for, but I got it. I hate the physics in this game. I almost feel there needs to be a trauma center for that shit. The physics in this game. $50 for a canister. Fuck no. Once you have a supply of better weaponry, you won't return to the sword. I can imagine. The sword promptly sucks, I tell ya. I don't know what the tower key was for. Because we could enter this before. But I guess we'll see. Are we enjoying this? As happy as ever. Yes, exactly like that. As happy as ever. Why am I getting pushed forward when I jump? There's a lot of loading times, yeah. Got him. It might be. It has to go through several virtualization layers. Oh, can I jump different heights now all of a sudden? I couldn't do that earlier. If I just jump straight up, I can regulate my height, but if I jump and then press right, I can't, then I'll go as high as I possibly can. So weird. Why do I save all the time? If you take so much damage from anything in this game. Almost anything you touch kills you. Or take away half your health. That's why I keep loading all the time. At least the saving time is very quick. Oh, I am getting better. That I can at least agree on. I guess I have to ask, how long is this? Is there a grey key above us? Like, how long is this game? Because I feel like it could be anything from very short to stupidly long. There it is, yeah. Exit booth. No, I can't exit that way. Really? Take quite a bit to learn. Now, okay. Walk into this thing here. So that's apparently a wall. Doesn't really look like a wall, but it is one. I wonder what I need the tower key for. Now we're back here. This is about where I'm pretty happy I have the shortcut. We've already gone through that hell. Screw it, I can never take one hit. I need to run to the bathroom really quickly. I'm about to pee myself, I feel. Be right back. Be right back, guys. Give me 5 minutes. There we go. That was probably quite quick. Frank never really understood what had happened to him. What? Wait, the fuck happened? The fuck? Here we go. The game break. I think so. Frank never really understood. Nah, that's true. Frank never really understood. Ah, another wobbly, walking piece of meat coming straight into my jaws. Boss? The fuck? Still like this. We'll load this one and I'll save as soon as we enter the boss. I also got myself a piece of... It's something my wife made. It's sort of like bread, but with bacon in it. It's really good, but I have no idea what I'd call it. I mean, she called it bacon bread. But I'd never heard about that before. Know what these things do. There be heads of both ends of it. Maybe it's two? Or one is an illusion? Wasn't a hint. I don't know. A weird ass creature, that's for sure. He doesn't fire until I'm too close. Right? Thank you. That's how you do it. Eat me! Now we suddenly have quite a lot of weapons. Really nothing down here. But I was trying to think, like, why can you travel through his body? There has to be a reason for that. The only reason I could think of is you have to do something inside of it. Need 7 red keys. So I tried to... And my first thought was actually that you were supposed to use a sword inside of him. To, like, cut him up from the inside. But it didn't work. Then my next thought was, alright, we'll try to blow him up, and that worked. Wait, was it really that quick to save? Apparently. Well, that was fun. I wonder if there's a hidden... There's a hidden path here somewhere. Yep. Well, a lot of these puzzles are pretty standard, I'd say. I've seen a lot of these tricks, sort of. At least like variants of them. All my mystery tournamenting is actually starting to pay off somewhat. I don't really know what I got from that, but... I need to take that hit. Take all that damage. Oh, it's the peacock. The labyrinth. For 25 handfuls. These were water bombs, 25 at 10. Handy shovel. Sure. Or what's this? Self-propelled fire, 25 of 25 shots. That sounds interesting. Currently out of stock. I am curious about the shovel. It's gonna take a while for it to pay for itself, but... I'm figuring sooner or later I'll be forced to dig somewhere. The digging sound, it almost hurts my ears. I just feel like eventually there's bound to be a puzzle where you're supposed to dig up a certain pile. Somewhere. Why does every enemy have to have a ranged attack? Someone could explain that to me. I'd appreciate it. Say what now?
Hmm.
a Pidgey. Alright. Whatever you say, Chief. There's the key. Alright. Cessios. I don't think you've been around before. Hello there and welcome. And if you have, sorry. Okay, blame my... Okay, blame a shitty memory. I mean, look at it, it takes like a quarter of my health away whenever I get hit. At least one of every weapon, sure. Okay, I definitely understood that with the bombs. It's good that you tell me that the other ones might be needed too. Upgraded or unlocked with higher grade weapons. Oh, alright, that's good to know. I found the door key. Question is just, where's the door? Well, that was a waste. Some stones? Ah, probably. But did they sell stones? I don't know if they did. I mean, they probably did.
Yeah!
Don't fool me twice. Did look very suspicious, didn't it? I don't think the money on the left is worth it here. I'll just settle for this one. Play a game of headball, slacker. What? Yeah, it does. What am I supposed to do? We get what we're supposed to do. It's just a bit tricky to execute. I think this is at least what you're supposed to do. What's that? I weren't allowed to leave the water. Let's Let's get the oxygen up that's down here too. Could have used the magic dust. Oh, this worked out pretty well too, I think. Stuns an enemy, huh? These flying fuckers are really annoying. Like, very annoying. Have I been here before? I don't think so. Elephant? Alright, so voting has opened. Shall we continue to play the fortune cookie? Get your votes in, folks. God damn it. So get your votes in. If you have an opinion, that is. Jesus, the platforming is so... I'm sorry, I don't have a bribe command as of yet. $5 bonus given. He doesn't sell walks. 25 to 25 shots, sure. 25 for 25 bombs. No, nah, it's not implemented. 100 for 10 mines. No. And 50 for 10. No. It's very unfortunate that they don't sell rocks. Yeah, I would have loved to buy rocks. I got hit on the way into the door. Nice. Fuck you, game. To some extent, we're all librarians. Alright. Right, we voted to continue. We'll do a bit more. We can destroy some floors with bombs. Oh. That's good to know. You can read these manuscripts. Ah, oh, okay, okay. Need to try that then. What the fuck? Meltdown ice floor, throw fire. Pick up bombs back up before they explode. Oh. Take screenshots by pressing hold. Destroy some bombs. If you're running and want to stop quickly, press down. Every summer when the moon goes full, Steve O'Brien acts like a fool. Inspired and moved by the tint of his jeans, he puts on his funny yellow jeans. In the shades of a tree, while the city drowses, Steve sticks a mouse in the pocket of his trousers. Like a ghost, he heads for the nearest 200, with a rodent in pants like cowboy with la- oh, near a zoo. Pants like cowboy with lazoo. Lasso and lasso doesn't rhyme or whatever. In the mist of the garden, with a victory drunk, he finds a creature with two tusks and a trunk. To let mouse go, Steve quietly squats, enjoying a trumpet of 500 watts. Well, that's how you move it. 1-3. Three. 100, 2, 1000, 5, 1100, 6, 105, 7, 2, wait, 3, 2, 110. Oh, let's see now. Stuff are sums of something, aren't they? 5 is the sum of 2 and 4. 6 is the sum of 1, 2, and 3. Alright, so 7 is 1,002. I guess. Or, no, 7 can be a lot of different things depending on how you combine the numbers. No wait, 5 is not the sum of 2 and 4. Well, 5 is the sum of 2 and 4. 6 is the sum of 2, 3, and 1. What is 7 the sum of? Oh, good question. I wonder where I'll need that one. Yeah, the elephant hint was actually really good. Yeah. I guess I sigh whenever I come across something, I feel like, ah, god damn it, this is. Killable, but very difficult. Okay, as I've said a couple of times, the controls are very tricky. It is very hard to get the characters to do what you want a lot of the times. Sort of like Syndicate, yeah. I guess that's why I sigh. It's like, oh, god damn it. God damn it. God damn it. That's why I keep sighing. I haven't got the fire powder yet. I guess I can't really get through here. Jesus. Dealt a lot of damage, yo. I don't know what to say about the visuals. It is very different from most of the Western style of graphics. In the tower where Blagon counterfeits his cookies, your fortune will be cooked. Like, you can... It's pretty easy to see that this is very different from... a lot of Western games. It's an interesting art style. It's like a mix of sort of like a mix of Asian style, like old Chinese, not old Chinese, but like how I imagine Chinese would make games in the early 90s. And it also contains Jesus. That car had completely wrecked its silencer. Or muffler. It sounded horrible. I do get a lot of vibes from like 80s China. Wait, didn't I hit that one? How was the original plot? Was the gameplay the same? Wait, I still don't have a mouse. Yeah, there's a lot of stereotypes when it comes to character rendering. That's for sure. To give back her peacock. Find my bird. Please give me, and I'll give you a lamb. Sure. Poor kid making long life cookies. Character who wants to laugh. Freshly tinned cookies. I don't know what the cookies would do, but I think I'll manage. 100 is a bit too steep. I was hoping that I could run through it. What the? There's a guy in the dark. Here in the labyrinth? Wait, the guy in the dark was behind the water area. I don't even remember meeting any guy in the dark. Thank you. What are with the bomb fishes? Is there a character in the dark? Unlock the first teleport leading to it. Down here? Oh, yes, I remember. Wait, where the fuck was he? The guy who was sitting in the dark. Eyes were forever in the gloom, but now I can read my book. I've been so long in the dark room. Give me the lamp and I'll give you a hook. A hook? Can't remember anyone asking for a hook either. Play Planescape. Oh. I don't even know what it is. Is there anyone in here? No, I've never played that. This one respawn? We can farm a lot of stuff by going around and around. On your quest to find a good game for you, that you're like, yeah, let's pick this one up, it might be good. It's mostly dialogue based. Yeah, it's that place that kills you. Dialogue ages well. If it's well written, yes. It indeed ages well. Reading. You just want to support that kind of game, probably then. To where the germs are having their brutal ball, make your way and may the needle be with you. What did that even mean? Oh, Yeah, I still can't do anything up here. Yeah, the hero wakes up with amnesia trope. Gets old pretty quickly, honestly. I've seen that one a couple of times by now. Let's go back to the labyrinth, I guess. Plague City, do I have this one? I don't think I've been there. I figured that'd be an enemy. Oh, there is the red key. Yeah, that FTL submission is close to impossible. I mean, by now when I sort of like start to get the game, I still can't, like I can barely beat it. I can barely beat it on normal. I've been close, but I never managed so far. Like beating it on hard. Beating it on hard is just impossible. I mean, it's not impossible, of course. I know others have done it. Yeah, gotta grab a vaccine and get away in a pretty decent health. Wait, you attracted again? That jump is difficult. You need to land in between the guy and the flame. I thought the entire idea of exceedance is that you can't get the disease again. I thought the vaccine would protect me too. Let's see if this works instead. No. I'll get to the key, then I'll go for the vaccine. But can I climb up there? Touching the fire instantly kills you. Oh, I want to save that one. Now I just need to get out of here. I haven't seen any other... It's of these. The fuck? Need a great key. This started pumps appearing in the city ponds, spreading germs since then. I had to destroy them all. We probably need to... Maybe we need to bomb them. We don't call this plague city for nothing. When I try to get down... I just want to like confirm my theory. Can I blow them up? Yes, so if we can. So that's sort of what we have to do, I guess. I get the plague as soon as I touch the water. This is not possible. There's another pump over here. I wonder what I'm supposed to do here. Wait, I don't get the plague from the water. Or was it because I was damaged? Oh, it comes from over there. There are other places. She doesn't really look like a goblin. Yeah, but I can't find the... The mouse. And also, I can't get out of here. As it is right now. Like, there has to be a way... There has to be a way to get out of this place. Oh wait, here's something. No, I don't remember that. Hello, handsome. I'm Prince Trifle. You must be Prince Charming. Listen to my plight. Crazy Dr. Fung has unleashed germ warfare on my city. His home is an odious laboratory where he breeds the foulest of bugs. Tread carefully, for those who've gone before you have their brains sucked out and pickled in yours. Nice. A huge chunk of cheese hanging from a rope. Oh yeah, 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 that part. I still need to get out of here though. Orient Express. There's a vaccine over there. I don't really need it right now. Keep the vaccine around should I need it. God damn it. How do I... probably bomb my way in somewhere. I seem to be hit. Seem to be hitting the bomb spots so often. I wonder if like every spot is a bomb spot. That's good at least. I'm practically dead. Old lad tried to gnaw his nuts but cracked his only tooth. He should have used a cracker. Tool wearing booze. Wait. Do you like the game? I mean, it's not bad. 50 bucks for a canister of air. It's not bad. It's not good either. Oh, do you like the game Geek Bot? Geek doing those space dodges Like a commander call. Like I said, there's nothing wrong with the game, or there's a lot of things that are wrong. But it's not bad, given when it's from and all of that. You get a lot of you get away with a lot for being like a bit innovative and old in my world. I excuse a lot. Old games, simply because they just didn't know better. Like, for being this old, it is pretty good, I'd say. And I can definitely understand why one would be completely enthralled by it back in the days, sort of. Wait, what? There's nothing here? Yeah, that's the thing with the nostalgia glasses. They do a lot of strange things to you. Magic powder. No, I want the... Is it these the rubber bombs? Seems like we're out. Screw you. I love this theme song here. I can imagine localization ruining a lot, yes. But I mean, the story that they present sort of makes sense. You're teleported to a magical wonderland. I just don't understand why the main character had to be like an agent. That felt very out of place. This game is tanking my viewer numbers. It's so difficult. Let me talk about that for a while here. It's interesting. If I wanted to get high viewer numbers, some games are very good at that. Syndicate was surprisingly good, actually. Did you see the amount of people that Syndicate brought here? It was pretty interesting. It was around 30 people for a while. Though that was a lot of hosts too, I guess, so... And it was probably a better time of day, so that matters as well. But sometimes... Like, games that I think would work really good... Yes, sometimes it doesn't. And it's very interesting. Sometimes I always almost think, maybe if you're going for viewer numbers, maybe if you should just do one and the same thing, like all the time. It's so interesting, I think... I thought variants... When I started this, I thought variants is one thing that people will really like to watch. But apparently not. Now I never thought I would be a big streamer, I really didn't. I never thought I'd be racking up the numbers, but it's very interesting today to see what brings people and what doesn't. But I mean, aren't... Aren't I almost doing a variety stream, sorta? We're doing a lot of different things. I don't actually know what exactly counts as a variety stream. What was like my idea, what would be my appeal, in my opinion, was actually the fact that I never expected people to be here all the time, because there will be games you just don't like. That I knew. I knew that was gonna be the case. But I did think more people would cycle through, because you never know what you might see. Like, one of the reasons why I watch Sharpie plays as much as I do, and why I watched TMR when he did Nismania, was simply because I like the ability of just tuning in, watching something I've never seen before for a while. Basically have to get past there without getting sneezed on, because otherwise the next part is just not possible, it feels like. And then of course there's always... Every stream eventually builds up a small core that's like always present, irregardless. Oh, magic dust. I really forgot about that one. I don't even know what it really does. If only you could kill these sneezing bastards. Oh! The voting is open! Shall we continue to play? Oh, that didn't help. The fortune cookie. Get your votes in, folks. Get your votes in. Yeah, like, I don't really know myself either. I haven't figured out the the formula that works. Yes, if I really wanted the big numbers, what I probably should do is play more known games. And... but then again, I really like this coming across games that I've never heard of before. It's like my entire drive behind what I do. I love coming across games like this, even if I don't like the game per se. I love the fact that I get to play games that I never would have come in contact with otherwise. This jump is just impossible. But like I never started streaming with the idea that I'd make money from it. Like the affiliate program didn't even exist back when I started streaming. Fuck! They sneezed on me while I was going through the door. And I got infected, right? Oh. So close. And like getting to partner has always been like it's nigh impossible, to be honest. Oh yes. Well, out she goes. Let's just make a save I'll remember. Back to main menu. And exit. Yes. What? Forgot to remove that one. I guess we completed the goal. I give it a passable. It's a bit too open for Mystery Tournament. Otherwise it would have been a pretty cool one. But yeah, due to the metroidvania style, never suits. A metroidvania style platformer with very limited weaponry and even more limited health. The sounds, yeah, I can see that. The game has a few pretty cool things going. The main one is the graphical style, which is very surreal and different is the best word I can come up with. The music little there is. Pretty fun, pretty interesting too. Oh god. The controls are pretty bad. And the amount of health you have make this game pretty painful. Sure, it is pretty old. So I give it the benefit of the doubt. But I can't really say I would wanna play more of this. So that's basically it. It's a passable game. Not much more. It's so wonky, that's the main problem with it. So quest is completed. Hurry up and join the loot.